The climate activists and all humans of today will be the accused business as usual of the future, except if all activists and all humans have an action plan in common and execute it. We humans already are divided about carbon dioxide emissions, so an action plan dominantly focusing only on reducing emissions of carbon dioxide will not readily lead to an action plan in common. Focusing on carbon agroforests produces, amongst many others, the yearly production of oil equivalent to Saudi Arabia for at least the next 10,000 years, and this in a renewable and superior form of the actual fossil fuels, etc., so this will more than satisfy those that see the necessity to focus on drill baby drill. The only resource needed for this immense and unedited production of renewables and effective horn of abundance will be exactly the 1.5 trillion tons of already emitted industrial carbon dioxide that right now is piled up in the Earth's atmosphere. This pile of carbon dioxide worries at least part of all humans. Seemingly ironic, and in what for some could seem a weird twist, a new and important member of the same drill baby drill party or group recently emitted a $100 million prize for a way or a method to remove industrial carbon dioxide from the Earth's atmosphere. A decade before another tecnocrate emitted a similar prize, this prize was checked in, and amongst the winners was the biochar concept. The biochar concept is a part of the carbon agroforest concept and lifestyle as practiced by our ancestors, still not more than a few thousand years ago. And somehow simplified and naively depicted in a millennium-old depictions of Adam and Eve, as related in the Bible and other actual religions and religions of the past. It is clear already by the makeup of the reactivists that the only common ground they will find and be sure of will be an efficient action plan, or rather an action plan based onto modern lifestyle adapted carbon agroforest approach and consequent horn of abundance, with clear benefits for health in its immediate wake. There is clear evidence of dense and advanced populations in the Amazon forest. Their lifestyles were sustainable and based on carbon agroforests. Their populations are proven to be as numerous or more numerous than that of Europe, which is larger in area than the Amazon region, still relatively close to the year 1500, which is the year of the for them destructive conquest. Before the conquest, they suffered yet other destructive events and divisions, which made the conquest relatively easy for the European invaders. Their carbon agroforest principles could be easily incorporated in modern lifestyles, including in cities. Religions and more recently business as usual, under the form of the early Darwinism, hid that from you. Early Darwinism started to gain ground only after we humans started to recover from centuries of Black Death and other epidemics of endemic zoonoses. By the way, Yersinia pestis, the main official causal agent of centuries of Black Death, is considered as re-emerging even by health organizations, almost right on spot with WHO warning of AMR, Disease X, breakthroughs of endemic zoonoses, and in 2020 some rather cryptic warnings for a perfect storm. While all that does not prove anything, it tells us we are not as good as we expected to be, and should be. By the way, we humans abandoned the carbon agroforest concept, only roughly 4,000 to 5,000 years ago, this in favor of bi-essential unsustainable agriculture with its essential plowing. By the time of the 3th and latest Bronze Age collapse 3,100 years ago, it was clear what the combination of abandoning carbon agroforest in favor of agriculture would bring us. It should be especially be clear in retrospect, but we are collectively blind to what thousands of years of history, collapses and diseases clearly tell us, that our history is a combination of collapses, diseases and conflicts. And it seems we are on the verge of the newest one. A problemless agriculture culture did not even last 1,000 years, which is a blip in our human history of at least 2 million years. We better avoid such an in all aspects disastrous thing, with an efficient action plan in common. The extreme health benefits of carbon agroforest are well documented and researched, but as expected not yet recognized by business as usual. Using the more than abundant carbon dioxide in the atmosphere to produce an alternative for fossil fuels, and also fulfilling what the CDR prizes have as main objective, clearly is a double whammy and winner, and means that the challenge as well as the division will be solved, and in theory the prize and the horn of abundance won, at least in a symbolic and or theoretic way. And that we humans have an action plan in common. To say the least, this is the soundest base for developing and agreeing on a global action plan in common. This even if geopolitics would divide us humans in two or more parties, anytime soon or in the future. The activists, most probably carbon agroforest activists, will have all the food and consequent health that carbon agroforests guarantees, as well as the consequent health and quality of life, that the former generation of rebellions of the 60s and 70s, that recently became the guilty business as usual, obviously does not feature anymore, this obviously is also age-related. But there is more to it than just age, amongst others cognitive decline, which is obviously also causing havoc in younger and the youngest generations. All other human parties and groups than the actual or rather new-to-come activists will have benefits too, and we all humans will thrive again, and conflicts including geopolitical conflict will ease, because no suffering humans will be left for dividing parties and geopolitics to exploit. Without an effective action plan in common, as it is still the case, all the actual humans systematically choose for, and or cling to what we call merely loose ideas, that we know in advance will not take any effort or commitment on our part, we will call it park and ride or simply park, and it is the motor and protector of business as usual and distraction from any effective action plan in common.